The primary role of any air force is to attain air superiority in the skies above the battlefield, and to provide close air support to the military forces fighting on the ground, so its armed forces can operate with impunity. The Turkish Air Force has always proved its capabilities and worthiness during armed conflicts in the past 80 years. The Turkey's main rival in terms of geopolitics is Greece. Both Turkey and Greece have fought many wars during the past 200 years. The last time both power fought an armed conflict was in 1974, during the Turkish invasion of Cyprus. Turkey was able to capture half of the island very easily because the Turkish Air Force attained air supremacy from the very beginning of the battle, as it had superior air forces compared to Greece. However, that's not the case anymore. The Greek Air Force is much stronger and larger than it was at the time of Cyprus crisis. And it's not only that, the Greek Air Force will soon receive even more sophisticated 4.5 generation fighter aircrafts from its French allies, which will change the balance of air power in the favor of Greece. And the Greek Air Force is not the only geopolitical rival of the Turkish Air Force. There is a sophisticated Israeli and a more numerous Egyptian Air Force that possesses clear edge over its Turkish counterpart, and then there is the Russian Air Force as well. So the Turkish Air Force is at a clear disadvantage against its regional adversaries. Turkey needed the induction of a fifth-generation fighter aircraft to keep maintain its air superiority in the region, but since Turkey was kicked out of the F-35 program due to its procurement of S-400 air defense system, they had no other option but to build its own fifth-generation fighter aircraft. The Turkish fifth-generation fighter program is the single most ambitious project of the Turkish defense industry. If Turkey successfully developed their indigenous fifth-generation fighter program, it will be a remarkable feat on its own, because so far only three countries successfully developed their fifth-generation stealth fighters. Developing a fifth-generation fighter aircraft is not an easy task to achieve. Apart from financial costs of the program, it requires immense technological know-how to develop such aircrafts. However, the Turkish aeronautical industries are manufacturing F-16 fighting Falcons since early 90s, and besides Turkey was also part of the 5th generation F-35 program, and were manufacturing its key components. So Turkey does have the required expertise and know-how to develop a 5th generation fighter aircraft. The TFX fighter's first prototype will be ready by 2023, and it will take its maiden flight in 2025. While it will enter into mass production by 2028. The Turkish firms such as Aselsan, Roketsan, BMC, and Turkish Aeronautics Industry are some of the top defense companies around the world. These Turkish defense firms are playing a crucial role in the development of a fifth-generation fighter aircraft for the Turkish Air Force. Now let's examine each aspect of the Turkish TFX fighter program. The Turkish National Fighter Jet, or the TFX, is designed by the Turkish aeronautics industry. The airframe of the TFX looks very similar to the F-22 Raptor, and this makes sense because most of the countries are developing their stealth aircrafts based on the F-22 design as it proved its worth. However, the TFX is larger than the F-22 Raptor, as it's 21 meters long and 14 meters wide. The TFX fighter will reportedly have longer range as it will be able to carry extra fuel internally. Just like any other fifth-generation stealth aircraft, the TFX will also carry its payload internally under the fuselage. It will be able to carry 4 long-range and 2 short-range air-to-air missiles in its internal weapons bay. However, the TFX can carry payload and extra fuel tanks on external hardpoints as well, but during aerial engagement that will not likely to happen as it will increase its radar cross-section and compromise its stealth advantage. The TFX will reportedly have a very low radar cross-section. Its radar cross-section will reportedly be between 0.01 and 0.1 meter square. However, we will be able to better analyze its radar cross-section once its prototype is tested against different radars. The TFX fighter will use an integrated cockpit display and will operate a three-axis fly-by-wire system. The canopy of the TFX looks a lot like F-22 Raptor, but we don't have any information about the materials they will use. The TFX fighter jet will operate active electronically scanned array radar with maximum range of 200 kilometers for a target with a radar cross-section of 1 meter square. The Turkish Aeronautics Industries and a Turkish firm named Aselsan are jointly working on the development of a highly advanced ESA radar for the TFX program that will use gallium nitride technology. The Turkish AESA radar will be ready for field tests by the end of 2022. However, the active electronically scanned array radars consume a lot of energy as they transmit radio waves with high frequency at longer distances. So Turkey will need powerful engines to power its TFX fighter jet, otherwise its ESA radar will be unable to work efficiently. The Turkish government talks with the Rolls-Royce for the development of a jet engine for TFX program has reportedly failed. However, the Turkish aeronautics industries and TR Motors have signed agreement to jointly develop a jet engine for the TFX program, which will be ready by 2029. Turkey will be able to power its TFX jet with the domestically produced engine only after 2029. So the prototypes in the first batch of the TFX fighter jets will use the General Electric F110 turbojet engines for power. Turkey can produce the F110 turbojet engines locally as they are already licensed produced in Turkey since early 90s. The TFX fighter jet will incorporate a helmet-mounted display. Turkish firms are working to upgrade the F-16's helmet-mounted displays to a fully integrated one. This will enable the pilot to focus more on combating the enemy rather than flying the aircraft. The TFX fighter aircraft will be equipped with advanced sensors, avionics and high-tech electronic warfare suit. Two Turkish defense giants, Aselsan and Havelsan, are working on the development of these critical technologies. Some of these sensors have already been developed, and are currently in testing phase while the rest of them will be readied before the first flight of TFX fighter aircraft in 2023. These two defense companies have successfully produced high-tech sensors for its F-16 fleet as well, so they do have the required skills and expertise. In terms of armaments, the TFX fighter aircraft will operate domestically produced air-to-air, air-to-ground and anti-ship missiles developed by Roketsan. The Turkish firm Roketsan is already producing anti-ship missiles as well as precision-guided air-to-ground armaments for the Turkish F-16 fleet. But it hasn't produced air-to-air missile yet. However, Roketsan is currently working on the development of an advanced medium-range air-to-air missile for TFX fighter aircraft, which will be ready by 2023. So overall, the Turkish TFX fighter aircraft will be a formidable fifth-generation platform which will give immense advantage to Turkish Air Force over its regional rivals. Once Turkey has considerable number of the fifth-generation TFX ready for operational use, it will give them a huge leverage over Egyptian, Israeli, and Greek Air Force because none of these regional powers have indigenous fifth-generation fighter program on the cards as of yet. So half a decade from now, Turkey will be leading the region with the only power developing their indigenous fifth-generation fighter aircraft, while most of its rivals will be acquiring aircrafts from other powers. That's all on the topic for now. If you like our content, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get updates about our future videos. Thank you and have a great day.